Hello everyone, and welcome back to Aarklash Legacy. Last time we ran past these head things and they started glowing. Or did they stop glowing? I don't even remember. Didn't they stop glowing when they... Oh, never mind. Now they are glowing. And it appears this wooden contraption thing is where we want to go. Yeah, okay, so the eyes didn't stop glowing, but the rest of the skulls did. Heads, whatever they are. And I still really don't know why and what that means. Now, maybe something happens when I've triggered all of them, or maybe I wasn't supposed to trigger any of them. But it's kind of too late for that now, I think. Okay, then back here should be another one. Okay, so to the best of my knowledge, that should be all of them. And it seems like nothing of import has happened. Oh well, perhaps it's just a bit of scenery. Okay, only Nella is now bound by contract to the guild and its final patron, Lokshai. Whatever purpose he has for her is still to be fulfilled. Since events began, she felt herself drawn, inexplicably knowing which path to take. She would face this fate alone, but she is thankful for her comrades in arms. Unbound, they could have deserted her, but the bonds of blood and steel run deeper than she thought.
We follow this blue spirit blindly?
I trust Nella with my life, as have you many times in the past.
Aye, she wouldn't lead us knowingly into harm.
And you know me, my sweet. I have a vested interest in my own hide, and I feel no danger from whatever creature it may be.
Still, I do not trust something that can appear and disappear at will.
That is a fair point, but we don't actually have a choice, do we now? Okay. So, I don't know what that's supposed to be, but there's a bunch of corpses on the ground. And more of these random canisters. Oh, Prowler of the Abyss, Master of Puppets, Incubus of the Despot? What does that Prowler do? Okay. He passively reduces armor. He has a standard attack, I guess. Okay, so this would be nice to be able to tell in advance when he's using that, because then you could use Mocha's reverse healing thing, which turns the restoring 100% of its HP into destroying 100% of its HP, which means it dies instantly. But it looks difficult to predict now. What's the larva doing? The Hemorrhage of Darkness. That's not too bad, but let's take it out anyway. The Master of Puppets, that sounds troublesome. Okay, so he's got a a crowd control ability that we can shut down because it takes 3 seconds to cast. Can reduce speed of attack, that's not too terrible. And he can channel an AoE magic damage field. He's still under mental control and oh, if I apply a control effect to the Master of Puppets, I will also suffer the effects. And he only suffers it for 50% of the duration. That's nasty. That means that I suspect it's time to switch to Denzel, who should be able to silence that thing. Okay. Well, I think I should be able to manage that just fine. Nella, you are fine. You've got your orders. Okay, so he's trying to use that crowd control effect on Nocker. Now, Nella, I want you to get out of the way. And on Nocker, if I now trigger the plasmatic silica, it should immunize me for 10 seconds against control effects. So that charm effect shouldn't do anything. And indeed it didn't, okay. So that's something I can work with. And now, Frinz, I do want you to essentially obliterate the Master of Puppets. Okay, he's now channeling that AoE thing. I'm afraid I'm just gonna have to tank that. Because if I shut him down, Nella will be shut down for substantially longer because she has weakness against control effects. Or anti-magic? I think control, though. But at least he doesn't have very much health, even though he just healed himself for 700 for some reason, and I don't quite know how. Okay, Nocker's doing fine. She's maintaining aggro. That guy's just channeling. What are you doing? No, actually. We don't want that.
Be here.
Okay, another few seconds and Frinz can destroy the Master of Puppets. And then we should be fine. Like so, and I guess we can keep the shutdown on that larva. Okay, that thing's trying to heal, which we don't really enjoy. Prince, keep going for that larva. Okay, so he just wants to regenerate for himself. I think that's okay. He's not currently my focus target. Nocker, get that thing back. And we may need to shut down this one until the taunt is recharged. Okay, I don't think I've got what it takes to interrupt that, so...
They are! You like that?
I can just heal the damage, that's okay. And now I guess everyone can just attack... Well, whatever.
Refreshing.
Taunt is recharged, so get the warrior back. Now, of course, for this situation, it would be ideal to have the AoE taunt, but... okay that we don't, I guess. And the next guy wants to attack Nella. There we go. Now everyone can just go for the Prowler of the Abyss. Which hopefully won't take too long. And then finally the Warrior of the Hydra. I think someone got a level up. Okay, Frinz definitely did. I can add a knockdown effect to my thermal pressure, which I think I'll do. Bolam. Might as well. Mocha, I'll improve the healing. Yeah, it's not bad. It's kind of a debuff and a heal in one. Like Loris, we can increase your fear effect so that it's faster to cast. Wenderu. Now this is a tough one. I don't want to really increase the Bloody Feast anymore because I feel it's already finished. And by the way, Wenderu is now level 20, which is the maximum. There's no next level experience, so yeah, she's maxed out. I could either improve the Leech Crane. Or the Mystic Predator. Might as well, I guess. Nella. She's now done as well, so I can make the heal even stronger. Denzel is also finished. And Nokka finally. Improving the range on the Neurotaunt, why not? Okay, well that's nice. Okay, it's not just going to be those four enemies, I suspect. Yeah, there's at least five now. Okay, I'll let this play itself out for a moment. That's an unavoidable thing. The Mage of Ruin, did that thing do anything nasty? Pretty sure it did. So, Frinz, you're on duty for destroying that. Nella, you're on duty for shutting it down. So, I'll start off with compressing. Then I will hit it with the sniping shot. The fire breather is doing its thing, which now it's no longer doing. No, Frinz, I want you to attack the Mage of Ruin. What's he doing now? He's trying to use a control effect on me. I am at this stage not immune against it, so I should be able to avoid that, hopefully, by just avoiding that projectile. Yes, that appears to have worked. Nice. Now... let's get that Scourge Bearer back. The other one, I'm afraid, we'll just have to deal with. Now... and how about we just shut it down for the moment? And that Reaper Priest can now die, that's very nice. Nella, you could, I guess you could get healed, that would be lovely.
Be healed.
And now Frinz, attack the Fire Breather. Again, usual thing. Weakening the armor first, and then going for, going for the sniper shot. Well, I guess we'll take Nella and Windru out of the range of that channeling thing.
And you die.
Good. Now Nokka can get this Scourge Bearer back. And I guess then she can protect herself again. And now it's just clean up. Okay. I'm not certain if they're just giving me tons of experience at this stage to make it possible for me to max my characters quickly. But Frinz got a level up, so he's now finished as well. Oh, and so did Mocha. I'm not so sure I want to use Mocha as a main healer. I might give it a try just for fun, I guess. Yeah, actually, why not? Firstly, Frinz can be replaced by Denzel. And Wenderu can go for Mocha. Okay. And this is experimental, it might not work. I've not used Mocha as a main healer for, well, forever. Oh, the Organist again. We did not like that thing, because what was it? It was immune against all control and anti-magic effects? Okay, only against control effects, so Denzel should be able to deal with it, I guess. Nokka, you only have your magic armor reduced, that's okay, you can put on your self heal. Now Denzel, I want you to attack the Organist, definitely. Nella, you can go over here. And I guess shut that one down. Oh, that one's immune as well. Wait, why did... did I accidentally try to target the Organist or something? Because the Destroyer of the Abyss should not be immune against... should not be immune against control my crowd control effects. Anyway, I'll get out of the way of that projectile thing, because it looks kind of painful. And now, Mocha. I need to really realize I have a different kind of healer here. I guess I can debuff that enemy. And then the heal just kind of bounces around. Put on a bit of a buff on Denzel, Okay. Now let me check the Destroyer of the Abyss. He is trying to cast Bond of the Hydra, which heals stuff all around it. And he's targeting it. He's casting it on the Organist. So let's try the anti-magic effect.
The power of the afterlife runs through.
Yep, that worked wonders. Nicely done. So that was the reverse healing effect, which turned the heal. And it was two heals, basically, from what I saw. He restored 400 HP to all allies within his within the range of the Organist, and within the range of himself, and because the Organist is so close, he got both of the heals, which means he got damage from both of the sources, because the heal was reversed.
The power of the afterlife runs.
Okay, and there we go. Now I can have Denzel attack the Destroyer of the Abyss already. Nice. And Mocha, how about we make sure Knockout doesn't take damage, and that instant everyone decides to break aggro. Wow. Okay, I don't really think I need much of a shutdown at this point. Yeah, I guess this can work. And Denzel, because his attacks automatically steal mana, he is very strong against that Destroyer of the Abyss. How about we debuff that?
I need your presence, spirit friend.
Nella, shut that down. Don't like channeled AoE attacks for some reason. Okay, the Destroyer of the Abyss should be dead reasonably soon. Let's get the Sun of the Hydra back. Okay, fine. How about this?
By the Furies!
Denzel, you're meant to be off damage, so please do off damage. Okay, that taunt is going to take a moment. Get Denzel up again. Okay, so let's see if that reverse effect works on the Warrior of the Hydra. It appears to. Nice. So his healing effect just became a degeneration effect. And so I'll use this opportunity to end the episode. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you again soon. Bye bye!